Welcome to our journey through Alipi's captivating backwaters. Nestled along Kerala's southwestern coast, Alipi, known as the Venice of the East, invites you with its serene waterways and vibrant culture. Come along as we discover this picturesque paradise, where iconic houseboats glide gracefully and local villagers extend their warm hospitality. So sit back, relax, hit the subscribe button, and let the beauty of Alipi's backwaters blow you away. Hello guys, and welcome back to Kerala, God's own country.
Today we are super stoked as we are going to do probably the thing we've most been looking forward to in the south. We are going to cruise down Kerala backwaters on a houseboat.
Super stoked, and we're literally just heading towards the boat now. The guys have picked up our bags. Wow, some of these houseboats are actually huge and look really, really fancy. We booked one that is around $50 per person, and it looks really, really nice online, so we're super excited to see it.
Some of these look like more like cruise ships than houseboats, don't they?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, bye.
Wow.
It's like walking the plank, isn't it, as a pirate?
Gaz has got no hands.
I'm good. Oh, thank you.
Watch me fall now. It's not the one.
Don't let's go.
Thank you.
Yeah, next one.
Yeah. Cool.
So it's a 4-bedroom luxury boat.
Wow, luxury. That's what we like to hear. Hello. Wow, this is nice.
This is so nice.
I honestly didn't expect it to be this big.
Yeah,
it's massive.
Four person.
I thought it would be like a small yacht you get.
Yeah, literally.
This is like about five times as big as I thought it would be.
And
Thank
in
you.
The morning we will give you 1 hour through and we will make you check out over here at 9 o'clock.
Okay, so we have just got our welcome coconut. First we're going to get this show on the road. El Capitano is going to set sail and then we will give you a tour.
And we're off.
Ahoy there!
Ahoy there! But listen to this. Silence. Silence in India. Absolutely beautiful, isn't it? You can barely even hear the engine. It just feels super peaceful and relaxing. No other boats cruising near us, just on the sidelines. And yeah, it's going to be hard to not feel like relaxed here. Okay, time for a houseboat tour. So we've booked this through Cruiseland Houseboats and we are stood right in the middle of the gorgeous living room here. So we've got cushions all around the edge and some nice wicker sofas in the middle with a little coffee table. So you've got loads of places to sit. If you come over here, where the captain drives his boat and where the best views of the boat are. But we have got windows all the way around. We've got the loveliest house pet here.
Let me kick it. I'm gonna kick it and see. Oh, that's my gammy toe.
Your feet are but for anyone that doesn't know, I'm actually travelling with my two best friends from university at the moment, hence why we've got two special guests on the boat.
They're not really your best friends, are they?
Yes, they are.
You said the other day you didn't like them.
We've known each other over around 7 years, so yeah, these two. This is Maddie, the ginger one, and then we've got Lottie over here,
the non-ginger one.
So you'll see these in the tour as well. Moving into the dining room area, so we've got a massive table with four chairs around. This is a four-person houseboat, so you know that's why we've got four chairs. We've got a huge TV here, which we won't be watching because obviously
put it on.
The best TV is actually right out here, so no need to look at the flat screen over here.
Football's on tonight, though.
And then if you follow me, we'll go into the bedroom area.
So into the bedroom we go. We have a large luxury double bed, a little desk there, but the best part is when you're lying in the bed you can actually see the views. You've got perfect views out the window to see the backwaters. Little bathroom and shower. It's actually nicer than a lot of the hotels we've been staying in, and it probably costs about the same amount as the hotel themselves, doesn't it?
And all foods included.
Yeah, all foods included. We had a coconut, but yeah, it's definitely a vibe. And yeah, should we see if we can get a sneak peek in the kitchen?
Yeah.
Let's ask him.
Has it got a sink?
Sink area. This is the girls' bedroom, it's just a mirror of ours.
Yeah.
And then the kitchen. Hello?
Yes, come on.
Can we have a look at the kitchen? Ah, thank you.
This is where the magic happens.
Ah, and you're preparing.
It smells lovely.
Delicious, isn't it?
And look, you've got the view out here as well.
Smells delicious.
Smells lovely.
Yeah. What have we got?
Pineapple,
curry.
Pineapple curry, buttermilk.
Oh,
nice.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
So lunch will be served very soon, so very excited for that. Now we've got a sneak preview. But everyone's just chilling out and just looking at these epic views. Look at it. There's nature all around us. It's truly magical. Look at this. Nothing better. So just in the distance here, you can see like all of the villagers and stuff who live along the backwaters, just doing their daily lives, washing their clothes, having a bath, sorting out their boats, some people walking along with their umbrellas, doing their shopping. It was really cool to see just like people going about their daily lives, and we could just cruise past them without like interfering or interrupting. But cool to see that people just live so naturally with the river as well and use it like as a resource. We've got a good breeze here, and look at this beautiful green field behind us. We've just docked up for lunch. Look at that. It's like a luminous green, like a highlighter. What are these called then?
Salt, lemon, beetroot, kale, buttermilk, yep. Pineapple curry.
Nice.
Cabbage and carrots, beans, salad, sambar, kela, sambar.
Sambar.
Our lunch spread is literally enough for probably about 8 people. Abby's going to try that.
Looks delicious. It looks like kind of like mashed vegetables.
Yeah, it's coconut and vegetables.
Let's give it a try. That is delicious. That is really, really nice. Have you tried that one yet?
Yeah.
Oh my god. It's like sweet because of the coconut, and then salty because of the vegetables. It's a really nice consistency, and it's got like cumin seeds in it. Ooh, I actually really, really like that.
It's like masala fish, basically. It's a very tender fish fillet with masala crumb around the outside, or like masala spices,
and yeah.
Ooh, it's good, a little bit spicy though.
Probably catch right out there. Well, we hope so.
So we have been given this dessert in a cup with a spoon called Pisum, and I'm going to try it for the first time. Not my favourite in the world, but yeah, it is nice. It just tastes like rice pudding if you have that back home. We have that in the UK and you like get it in a tin, but I guess it's quite similar, like a quick instant dessert. But yeah, it's nice.
Well, that was absolutely delicious. Sent everyone into almost an early grave now. Everyone's having a snooze because it's absolutely boiling today. It's like 35 degrees, it feels like 40, and the humidity is insane. But yeah, food was out of this world. The best meal we've had in India so far. Delicious. Oh, the roll again. Tea time. So as we sipped in our coffees, the gentle rhythm of the backwaters lulled us into a state of relaxation. The soft lapping of the water against the houseboat, the rustle of the breeze through the palm trees, it was pure bliss. A day hasn't gone by on our holiday without a game of cards. With each shuffle and deal, we found ourselves drawn into the game, laughter mingling with the sound of cards being played. Here, in the heart of nature, there were no deadlines to meet or emails to answer. All that mattered was the company of good friends and the beauty surrounding us. After an hour of pure bliss, we snapped out of our trance as the boat cruised into a large lake.
We have just come out of the backwaters now and we are on, I think it's called Punamanda Lake, which is where the really, really famous snake boat race happens once a year, and it attracts hundreds of thousands of tourists from around the world. So it's a shame it's not going on now. We could be sitting on the houseboat watching the old snake race, couldn't we? Come on, come on!
Well, there's like loads of boats over there.
Now 10 to 5 and we got told by our captain just before we set off that you have to be docked by 5 p.m. So we're pulling into what feels like more of a village rather than like the empty streets of the backwaters. He's not really found anywhere just yet, but he's got to be docked in 10 minutes.
Sure, he's got a spot in mind.
We get to then get off the boat. We've not actually seen the outside of the boat yet and get to explore the little areas as well. So that's quite exciting because we've been on the boat all day. It's been very warm. So to stretch our legs and explore the other areas will be very exciting.
Thank you, Captain.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Here we go. Land for the next hour.
Land ahoy!
Now we finally get to see our actual houseboat from the outside. So this town as well is actually our chef's town. So he was like, yes, go and explore. Rice fields down here, shops here. So just a nice little stroll along the river.
Yeah, actually, I was actually thinking, is he gonna stay on our boat or do you think he'll just cook and like walk to his village and come back in the morning maybe?
I think he's gonna come back for dinner, didn't he? He's going up for an hour or whatever. But it's nice to be up close and personal with everything we've been seeing from the boat. So that little boat there looks like a little taxi boat. So obviously a place filled with water with loads of like rivers and little canals and stuff. You can get on a boat to navigate across the river, which is very clever. So there's lots of people getting on and off in like a hop on, hop off boat. As we stepped off the houseboat and wandered into the nearby village, we were greeted with smiling faces and warm welcomes from the locals. It's evident that the villagers are genuinely happy to see us, their hospitality making us feel like part of their community.
Camera. So we're just reflecting on the past week or so, and Kerala has definitely been one of our favourite parts of India. Oh, dodge a tree so far. Yeah, it's absolutely beautiful. We're just cruising through the backwaters and I was like, this is one of the things that lives up to its hype.
Yeah.
There's so many times you get like hyped up about the top thing to do and then you come to it and it's good, but it's not what you expected. But yeah, this is even more beautiful than I thought.
Our chef then led us down a path to show us his house, nestled amidst a stunning backdrop of vibrant emerald green rice fields. We paused to admire the sunset as it dipped below the horizon. That was a delightful walk around the village, watching the sunset, and now we're back on the boat, just waiting for dinner to be served. We've got ourselves a lovely dal, some nice white rice, another concoction of like coconut vegetables, some more vegetables because us three are vegetarian on this trip, and then Gaz has got some nice chicken and some chapatis, so delicious. But I think we're going to spend the rest of the night playing cards, drinking some wine and just chilling out, so we're going to see you in the morning. Good morning, guys. We woke up this morning to the sound of some very relaxing Indian music playing as the sun rose. We pulled the curtains open. It started playing like maybe at like 5:30, 6 a.m. and the sun rose at 6:30. So we just watched the sun rise from our bed. It was really, really beautiful. And now look at this, the sun's rising just here. So we've parked it perfectly to see the sunrise, which is beautiful. I'd love to say that I slept well, but it was no problem with the boat. It was more I woke up at 4 a.m. My mind was just going a million miles an hour. I just had one of those nights, but the bed was super comfy.
Morning.
Morning, love.
Morning, geezers.
How did you sleep?
Yeah, fine. Good. It was particularly nice 6 a.m. music blasting, but yeah, it was kind of peaceful.
Watched the sunrise in bed, didn't we?
It was nice, yeah. So it was either light switch on or light switch and fan on or fan off though, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So when the aircon went off at like 6:42 or something random, it was time to turn the light on with the fan.
Oi, oi.
For breakfast we have the standard omelette in which we seems to be getting everywhere, but can't complain. Toast. These pancakes, which are full of like sugar and curry spices. I don't know if they're like masala pancakes.
Time to take one last look, guys, because we are currently pulling into port at 9 a.m. But we're going to be very, very sad to say goodbye to these beautiful views. Yeah, the only thing that we'd say is we wish that this was just slightly longer. Like, I wish we sailed in the morning to like 1 o'clock in the afternoon or something.
Yeah, really, if you've got the funds for it, I don't know if you can do 2 days, but I wish we were doing 2 days. It's just so relaxing.
Yeah, it's been one of our favourite things that we've done in India, and yeah, we've really, really enjoyed Kerala, haven't we?
We have.
So if you've enjoyed this video, make sure you give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next video where we'll be exploring Kochi. Bye!